A centrifuge is a machine that spins samples very quickly. It causes solids to settle out of suspension in liquids. And this video is to show you how to use a centrifuge. There's one of these on every bench, and you will be sharing the use of them with other people. You will use the centrifuge tubes that you've got in your lab. These are 15 mil centrifuge tubes. You don't need to have a cap on them. You may well have a sample that is in a smaller tube. I've got one here. Do not put the glass tube directly in the centrifuge. Let's open the lid here. It always, if it's a small tube, it goes inside a centrifuge tube that's tapered at the bottom. It's designed for this purpose. Now, a centrifuge has 6 slots in it, and they're numbered 1 through 6. Try and remember which one is yours, because they all look the same, you will get confused. The loading of a centrifuge needs to be even. Let me show you what happens if it isn't even. If you put just one tube in by itself, turn it on. This is not what you want to happen. So make sure that your centrifuge is always balanced and it will not try and dance across the floor and make loud and upset noises at you. And it's not just because it's making a noise, you're actually damaging the machine to do that. Here I have a sample that has a solid precipitate in it, but it hasn't settled out. So I put this inside a centrifuge tube, and because I don't have somebody with me, I'm using a second tube weighted approximately equally, and you put it across the rotor so that it's balanced. If you've got several people around, you can share and balance the centrifuge using several samples at the same time. There are 6 spots inside the centrifuge rotor. You should balance the load. That means have things placed symmetrically around the axis. You can do 2 opposite each other, 3 or 4 or all 6. The only pattern that will not work is 1 and 5, because those are prime numbers, they don't divide evenly. If you have one of your own, by yourself, no one else, then just take a second centrifuge tube, put water in it to give you a reasonable balance, and then away you go and spin. Normally, there will be other people around you, and you can share the spin with other people. All right, let's now try spinning my sample, which is in slot number 4. Take my sample, close the lid, and turn the spin on. Doing it for about a minute is enough, and you notice that this is not dancing all over the bench, it's not making loud thumping noises. This is indeed properly balanced. The switch on the machine is actually clockwork. When you crank it up, you can set it for an appropriate amount of time. It's now been 1 minute. The switch has turned itself off, and it is spinning down in terms of speed. You need to wait until it's not whizzing around at high velocity before you open the lid. This is getting pretty close to slowed down and stopped here. And spot number 4, this is now my tube, and you'll notice at the bottom here that the solid has gone all the way to the bottom of the tube. You can now remove this with your tweezers, and away you go. That's how you should be using a centrifuge.